I'm Nancy Drew. This is my center of operations, my desk. Go ahead and poke around. If you want to know the particulars of how I do what I do, take a look at the book titled How to Be a Detective. It's real helpful, especially if you're new to the mystery-solving business. And be sure to check out my scrapbook. I put memorabilia from all my past cases in there. A lot of them were pretty dangerous and at times really scary. But don't say anything about that to my dad, okay? He worries about me enough as it is. And whatever you do, read what's in the file called Case File. That'll tell you all about the mystery I'm about to try to solve. If you think you're ready to dive into that mystery, just click on the plane ticket and you'll be on your way. It looks like a piece is missing.
What's going on?
If you weren't going to be the best man, how come you came out here so early?
I volunteered to help get everything set up, and Matt and Kyler took me up on it. I'm pretty good friends with Kyler, too. In fact, I'm the one who introduced her to Matt.
How long ago was that?
A little less than a year ago. They both claimed it was love at first sight, and it seemed like it really was, right up until a couple of days ago. You sure do ask a lot of questions. Wait a minute. Nancy Drew! Kyler told me about you. You're the girl who likes to play detective.
Well, it's just, you know, kind of a hobby. Although Kyler did say it'd be nice if I could find Matt.
Well, you're not gonna have any luck doing that. Old Matt is long gone.
Kyler says sometimes she hears Matt's voice, only it's very faint and muffled. Do you ever hear him?
No. Man, Kyler must be losing it or something, because I'm telling you, Matt is not here.
The caretaker seems to think you're the one who should be getting married here, not Matt.
Yeah, well, in case you haven't noticed, that guy's got several screws loose. I just happened to mention that 3 out of my 4 grandparents were born in Ireland, and now whenever he sees me, he gets this weird look in his eye.
But you don't think he had anything to do with Matt's disappearance?
No. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. He and Matt did not get along. They were always at each other's throats, arguing about the stupidest things. Even those leprechaun gnome things out in the garden. Donal had a fit one day when he saw Matt messing with them. And when Matt announced he was going to stay in the haunted nursery, I thought the guy was going to burst a blood vessel, he turned so red. But Matt disappeared on his own, not because of anything Donal did. I mean, the old coot's not that crazy. Is he?
From the looks of that picture I found over there, it looks like you and Kyler used to be a lot more than friends.
Yeah, we dated for a while, until it finally became obvious that we were better as a couple of friends than as a couple. No biggie.
That discussion you had with Matt, come on, really. What was it about?
It was about Kyler. I was asking Matt whether he had truly thought through what being married to her was going to be like. The more questions I asked, the more nerves I struck, and the more uncomfortable and angry he became, until finally...
He gave you that shiner.
He stomped upstairs to the nursery. Next day, he disappeared. Obviously, the things I said got to him. So if I seem a little guilty to you, it's because I am guilty. It's my fault that Matt walked out on Kyler. Simple as that.
Have you ever been up in the tower?
Uh-uh. You saw the stairs, or what's left of them. There's no way to get up there.
I could have sworn I saw lights coming from it.
Perhaps it was the good people come a-callin' on their good friend Anal. Or maybe it was just reflected moonlight or something.
So if you're thinking Matt's up there, forget it. Ain't no way.
I'd better get going. See ya.
Drop by anytime.
What is that?
You're right. There has to be a logical explanation for what we just saw. So I'm going to calm down, relax, and trust that you will discover what that thing was. You are going to figure it out, aren't you, Nancy?
I promise.
Looks like I need a key. Ew!
What's on your mind, then?
Sometimes I hear this strange kind of wailing sound when I'm in the castle. Have you ever heard it?
These ears don't work so well now. Even the pattering of rain is beginning to slip by them. But the situation being what it is, by my reckon, a banshee you heard.
You mean someone in the castle is going to die?
Aye.
Someone as in Matt?
How they know what they know, and why they do what they do, are mysteries far beyond mortal solution. But be assured, lass, someone at Castle Malloy is doomed.
Have you ever been to the other side of the bog?
Do I look daft to you now? There's no walking across the bog. Once you fall in, there's no getting out. Oi, when I was your age, younger even, there was talk of an old gypsy woman who kept house in the bog, living all by herself, crazy as could be. But a tall tale is all it was. You stay clear of that bog, girl. There be no crossing it. Not if you're fond of living.
I'd better get going.
Fine with me.
What's going on?
I found the sketch you did on the ground outside. What's it for?
What, that? I was just messing around. See, I'm into real estate, and whenever I see an interesting tract of land, I like to sketch out how I'd develop it. Just to, you know, keep the juices flowing. It doesn't mean anything. I was just doodling.
Great, so it's okay if I keep this?
Sure. Go right ahead.
Have you ever been to the little hut that's in the middle of the bog?
No. Don't tell me you've been traipsing through the bog. Are you nuts? That stuff's like quicksand.
Did Matt ever try to cross the bog?
The only thing Danal ever said that made sense to Matt was, stay away from the bog. And he did. And you'd be well advised to do the same.
I'd better get going. See ya.
Keep it real.
You have a lead?
Mostly I have a question. Do you know anything about this sketch? I found it outside.
It looks like a drawing for some kind of housing development, for the land the castle sits on.
Apparently Kit did them. Did you ask him to?
No, and I seriously doubt Matt did either. Kit must have done those on his own. The question is, why? Anyway, I thought of something else you can do for me. Since there's a possibility, however remote, that there are forces at work around here that none of us completely understands, I think it only prudent to do what I can to counteract them. To that end, I would like to include these herbs and flowers in my wedding bouquets. According to Irish lore, each of them is believed to be associated with things I could use a little more of right now. If you could pick them for me and put them in that vase over there, that would be wonderful. Here's a basket. This, of course, means that in spite of whatever it was I saw in the nursery, I still believe there will indeed be a wedding, because no matter who or what took Matt, you're going to find him, Nancy. I have to believe that. Please don't let me down.
I'll let you get back to your reading.
As soon as you find out anything, let me know.
Thank you.
That sheep doll needs stuffing. To stuff that sheep doll, I'm going to need more wool.
Thank you. Those were just some sketches I made because I was bored. I do that all the time. I'm not after your property.
Then what are you after?
Nothing.
Then why are you trying to tell me there's not going to be a wedding?
Because Matt is gone.
Matt would never walk out on me. Never.
He still loves you, Kyler, but he's not ready to get married, and he just didn't know how to tell you.
Oh, so he told you to tell me. Or was his leaving your idea? What'd you tell him, Kit? That I still had feelings for you? That it isn't over between us? Because it is. You know that, don't you? It is most definitely over.
What's going on?
I found Matt's luggage in here, right over there.
What? Over where?
It was behind the cots.
How'd it get there?
Looks to me like someone was trying to hide it.
Well, it wasn't me. Matt hid it. Oh my gosh. He didn't go back to London. He's been here the whole time. Kyler was right. Oh my gosh.
You sound kind of disappointed.
Marrying Kyler is the biggest mistake he could possibly make. If this means that's what he intends to do, you bet I'm disappointed.
I couldn't help but overhear the discussion you and Kyler had in the library.
That sure didn't go like I planned. All this talk of fairy kidnappings and practical jokes, I just thought it was time to clear the air, but what happens? Not only did she accuse me of being the bad guy in all this, but as it turns out, she had it right, and I had it wrong. Matt didn't walk out on her. His luggage proves it.
The part about you're still having feelings for her, was she right about that too?
Yeah. As for what, if anything, I'm gonna do about it, I haven't quite figured that out.
Time for me to scoot.
Drop by anytime.
Here are those flowers and herbs you asked for.
Splendid. You've picked all the flowers?
Yep.
Go ahead and put them in that vase.
There you go.
Splendid. Anything else to report?
I found Matt's luggage hidden behind the cots downstairs by Kit's things.
How did it get down there?
It kind of looked like Kit was hiding it.
Oh, don't be silly. Why would Kit do a thing like that? Well, anyway, that's a good thing. It means Matt's still around here, just as I've been saying all along. Anything else to report?
I'm gonna go play detective now.
Anytime you want to talk, I'll be right here.
Still have to do that. All done. All done. Did that. Check. Did that. Did that. Can't check that off yet. I haven't done that. Check. Check. Did that. All done. Can't check that off yet. All done. All done. Did that. All done. Did that. All done. Did that. Check. All done. Check. All done. All done. Did that. Check. Check. All done. Still have to do that. All done. All done. Can't check that off yet.